set you apart. I don't know what you want me to do or how you want me to do, but you tell me what you want me to do and I give it my best. That sets you apart. I don't have to have a mic. You know, but if you give me the mic and you tell me what you want me to do, well, then I'll do what you told me to do and say, I ain't gotta be up there, you know, they give you 2 minutes to testify and you up there 15 minutes late. What are you talking about? And you got to remember this now. If you got 2 minutes and you use 15, you've just been disobedient to your instructions.
This is not your move.
She must stay there.
Always learn to obey.
Yes, sir.
The phrase, obedience is better than sacrifice, will never go out of style with God.
For real.
I don't care what dispensation it's in, it will never go out of style. God will always stand behind those that will obey. So David let him know, saying, see, you done messed up now. And the same phrase, the same mental thought that David had as he addressed Goliath is the same mental thought that you should have when you're dealing with the devil.
Come on,
David.
Mm-hmm.
Well, they over there running me now, and I'm finna give them a piece of my mind. Come on now. Come on now. You know you only got one piece left. You finna get out of the way. You gonna be out. You gonna be out, God. And what you want to do is you want to say, well, Lord, help me. And talk to God. Tell God. Say, now, Lord, you know how I am. Now, you know, Lord, I ain't on this stupid stuff. You know, if I had my way, I'd go over there and snatch a knot in one or two of them and just growl at the other ones and never run them out. If I had my way. So, Lord, tell me what to do. And he'll tell you, go over there and be pleasant.
Mm-hmm.
Be pleasant. Ooh-wee. You go over there and you're talking to them, and then they say something, and you feel like they're talking about you. Everybody laughs because they know the joke, but you. God says, stay, don't leave. You're like, give them a hug. Buy ice cream for everybody. That's how God will do you. Mm-hmm. And what you be mad about because you wonder, why don't he do that to them? And the answer is, who said he didn't? Maybe they chose not to obey.
That's right.
But you claim you want to be saved. You know, when you decide you want to be saved, the first thing God do, and I'm saying it this way, is test you.
Amen.
Is test you. And he take you to the one place you don't want to go.
No,
it happens. He tests you to show you that you was lying about what you said. Then they ask you, why'd you lie? I didn't lie, Lord. I meant it. But, ain't no buts. Direct order. And so David now is saying to this guy, you have defied God.
Yes.
And anybody, I don't care who they are, I don't care what their anointing is, and this is what the scripture is showing us. There's no size, there's no wisdom, there's no strength of no sort that once it defies God, cannot be reckoned with by God.
Yes, sir.
Ain't nobody gonna tell me this boy can beat this man with 5 rocks. I'm not gonna buy that.
Right.
This fella been killing folks. He probably go into battle and with one swing kill 3 people. That's how big the sword is. And he probably just cut through bodies. Arm and everything.
Jigsaw.
David up there with some rocks. You better go. remember what we're saying. It's the plan that God has for David. See? Now don't get me wrong. David was not at home with the sheep. And it came to him, thus said the Lord God. On tomorrow, Jesse's going to send you out to your brothers. When you get to the battle, inquire about the Philistine. And when you draw near to him, you tell him you're going to kill him in the name of the Lord. He didn't get that.
Amen.
He was delivering bread like his daddy told him and why. God ain't told him nothing. He ain't heard nothing. He just know. We are supposed to simply know that this is right to do and this is wrong to do. I'll do what's right to do. It's going to hurt. I don't like it, but I'm going to do what's right to do. We always want the Lord to speak. Pick the thing on your left. It is of me. And most of the time when you get that voice, it's the devil. That's the devil, because he has transformed himself. And he got that deep voice too. Pick the thing on the right. It's me. Like, well, that was a whore. Because he got that voice, because you heard it on TV. He just watching the Ten Commandments. Did y'all hear it? Y'all hear the voice of the Lord when you watch the Ten Commandments? Oh, man, you never seen it. No wonder you all messed up. That's because, and listen to me. That is how we would depict God if we were doing it. That's how we do it. You get God's money. Take the bank on the left. That's me. Ain't nobody, who gonna give God one of them voices?
You are my children.
That don't even sound godly. But I'm just saying, so the operation comes out of the mind of what we've conceived, and it matches it so we can roll with it. But that's the thing. Now David did not get any information from God that he was going to be in battle with a giant tomorrow and God was going to help him slay him. David went out and he simply believed. Had faith that I can go in the battle, I can beat this guy. Because why? Because he blasphemed my God. He cursed the people of Israel. He's holding the armies of the living God at bay. David can't get over this guy. Who do you think he is? You have to realize there are some folk that are so arrogant, they think that if they don't approve it, God don't. And they'll make you believe that. They'll make you feel that. But don't let them make you believe that. I know what the Lord said. Amen. The one thing I know about God, if he dealing with me and talking to you, that ain't going to work. That don't work. And he know I'm like that. It ain't made up. It's just who I am. So God going to come directly with me because he know where to find me. And if I don't understand, he has a way of saying, oh, no. This is what I want. That's why I come typically in the church. You don't need nobody to come prophesy to you. You just want somebody to prophesy to you. You don't need that. Oh, a prophecy is already written. The word of God is already defined. What do you need? It just sounds better when somebody says, honey, the Lord told me to tell you. You feel like, oh yeah, that'll work. That'll work. And then when it don't come out, you're going to say, well, so-and-so said, and all of heaven is laughing at you like, you idiot. They said God said. Because you want somebody to be able to point to something instead of having God direct and guide you.
Oh my God.
Simply, nobody in this room loves you more than he do. I don't care what none of them say. I don't care how much money they give you. I don't care how many times they take you to dinner. Sweet talk you, sour talk you. Whatever they did, nobody in this room loves you more than Jesus.
Amen.
Now, that's something you have to believe. Because if you believe somebody do, then they do. To your belief. But when you find out, you're going to be hurt.